Hello everybody, I am Thorstein from Cinema Terror, and today I will be talking about the upcoming horror movies we can expect to see in 2017. There are only 2 days left of 2016, so most horror sites have released their best of list of this year's horror films. If you're into podcasts, then I would recommend checking out the Shockwaves podcast, where they go through their best of list, and just in general, check out Shockwaves, they are awesome. If you're familiar with my channel here on YouTube, then it shouldn't come as a surprise that I won't do a best of list of 2016 yet, as I don't focus all that much on current horror movies. I would like to say though, that if I would put up a top 3 of the 2016 releases that I have seen, then I would put Train to Busan on top, as it is an amazing film, perfect to be watched on the big screen. It has some scares, plenty of action scenes, and even a scene where I nearly teared up. The Conjuring 2 was cool, a bit over the top at times, but that's to be expected after the first one. That one also had some tender moments, and James Wan is really an amazing director that I hope won't leave horror behind now that he has other big projects going on. And finally, I have to give some praise to The Autopsy of Jane Doe by Norwegian director André Øvredal. Great little horror film that I'm happy to see that people seem to enjoy. So, let's talk about the New Year's and 2017. I have a total of 35 movies to talk a bit about here, which was way more than what I was expected to cover when I started making this list. Surely not all of these will see a release in the upcoming year, but I have made an attempt to exclude movies that are still in pre-production or just looks unlikely to be released in 2017. The funniest thing about making lists like these are that at the end of the year, when the best of 2017 list have been created, we are bound to find movies that no one even knows about yet. That's how it works in this genre, and I wouldn't want to have it any other way. Well, since this will be a long video, I'll just go right ahead and start talking about the movies, which I've listed in alphabetical order, as release dates are never to be trusted. So here are some horror movies we can expect to see in 2017. Alien Covenant will be the sixth movie in the Alien franchise, that is, if you include the Prometheus movie, and don't include the Alien vs. Predator movies, which in my opinion at least is a different beast all of its own. Ridley Scott is continuing what he started with the original Alien movie and his prequel Prometheus, with his sequel that will bind both of those movies together. Even if Prometheus got a bit of a lukewarm reception, I personally thought it was a fun sci-fi movie, so I'm curious to see how the story continues in Alien Covenant, which will hit theaters worldwide from the 18th of May. So when the fuck are we getting Amityville The Awakening? The film was supposed to be released in January of 2015, before getting postponed time and time again. The last release date we had for this Dimension Films, Miramax and Blumhouse production was January the 6th of next year, but now it has, surprise surprise, been postponed yet again. The new release date is now June 30th, but I wouldn't hold my breath for that one either. And I don't really get it, as the trailer makes it look like a perfect type of horror movie to be released back in 2015. If they don't hurry up soon, the film will be more dated than what it probably already is. What's sad about is that this is the first Amityville movie I've been excited about in years. Yeah, it looks like it has some typical ghost jump scares that we've gotten used to in the last 10 years, but this one actually looks like it was made by people who have seen the original Amityville horror movie. And when you look at the credits, you will see that it has been both written and directed by Frank Calhoun, who did the awesome Maniac remake with Elijah Wood. So to all you companies that control this movie, fucking release it next year, will you? I'm sorry, but I'm unable to let any movie with the Amityville name in it pass me by. Even if it is a title as stupid as The Amityville Exorcism, and it is being directed by the guy behind Holla If I Kill You, Camp Blood First Slaughter, and Sharkenstein. He also did another Amityville movie back last year called Amityville Death House, which I will admit that I haven't gotten around to viewing yet. The trailer looks crappy, but hey, at least it cannot be any worse than the Amityville Haunting, which came out a few years ago. And as mentioned, I'm in for any movie with the Amityville tag on it, regardless of what quality it might be in. Amityville Exorcism is slated to be released on video on demand and home media sometime next year. Hitting the theaters on August 11th is Annabelle 2, the sequel to the successful Conjuring spin-off from 2014. While I do like the Conjuring movies, I did not care for the Annabelle standalone at all. And I can't say that I'm excited about this new one either. It is being directed by David F. Sandberg, who did this year's Lights Out, so if that was a movie enjoyed, then you should make a mark on August 11th to go see Annabelle 2. Since I did not care for either Lights Out or the first Annabelle movie, I'm most likely gonna skip this one. The Bride is a Russian film that will be released in its home country on January 19th. This gothic story has a production budget of little above $1 million, and the trailer has enough good stuff in it to make me interested in seeing the final product, whenever it will be available with English subtitles. This is a film I'm going to guess many people haven't heard of, so make sure you check out the trailer for The Bride. If it intrigues you as much as it did for me, then we both have something fun to look forward to from a country that is known for its horror movie output. The Bye Bye Man is a film that will hit theaters on January 13th, and most likely will make back its $6 million production budget on horror-hungry teenagers calmly awaiting the next jump scares galore that this surely will be. I did not care for the trailer of this at all and will not be watching this unless it gets some good receptions by people that I trust the opinion of. It is also worth noticing that the Bye Bye Man has a female director in Stacy Title, who has worked in the horror genre before as she has the honor of being the director of Snoop Dogg's Hood of Horror from 2006. Following the success of this year's big shark movie, The Shallows, is an Australian movie called Cage Dive, which will get released sometime next year. While shark movies in the last years has been dominated by ridiculous concepts such as Sharknado and the likes, Cage Dive will try to do what The Shallows did in creating suspense instead of laughter. The trailer for the film is out and there is some nice shots in it, so if shark movies are your thing, then make sure you check out Cage Dive. Yay, finally a new Children of the Corn movie is about to be unleashed upon us. This will be the 10th movie in this never dying franchise, and this time the director will be John Gulager, the guy behind the Feast trilogy and Piranha 3DD. This franchise does the same for me as any movie with the Amityville tag in it, and I know I shouldn't, but I still can't help to watch them all. There are hardly any details out regarding what this movie will be about, except that it of course will involve children and corn. But then again, who cares? It's Children of the Corn 10 for Pete's sake. Don Mancini has confirmed a few months ago that he's working on the 7th Chucky movie. The last film in the series, Curse of Chucky, went straight to VOD back in 2013, and I'm gonna guess that this will have the same fate. I actually skipped the last one, but big fans of the killer doll should be happy to hear that he will return once again, and chances are high that it will be out before the next year is over. If you were in the crowd that disliked the 2008 straight-to-video remake of George Romero's Day of the Dead from Steve Miner, then you can clap your hands and make a happy face and eagerly anticipate another remake of Day of the Dead, coming in 2017. This remake seems to be a bit bigger, with an estimated production budget of $10 million. It is being directed by the Spanish director Hector Hernandez Vicens, who previously had done The Corpse of Anna Fritz. I am more interested in watching that one instead of this remake, but for those who cannot get enough of the undead walking the earth, then you got another one to look forward to. Oh, and they are bringing the Bub character back, so yeah, there you go. Deathhouse has been called the Expendables of the horror genre, as this upcoming horror film has gathered together a group of horror icons. The impressive cast list includes people like Adrienne Barbeau, Barbara Crampton, Brinke Stevens, Lloyd Kaufman, Kane Hodder, Michael Berryman, Tony Todd, and many, many more. I might not be all that excited for this after seeing the trailer, but for big fans of these guys, then the film will surely be an interesting experience. Although the new Friday the 13th movie has a release date in upcoming October, it should be said that it has taken several years for now to get this new one on the way, and this one hasn't started filming yet either. The newest director attached to bringing Jason Voorhees back to the big screen is Breck Eisner, who did The Last Witch Hunter and also The Crazies remake from a few years back. I still haven't gotten around to seeing the previous Platinum Dunes remake of Friday the 13th for some reason, but I am happy to see that Jason is still around 35 plus years since he first jumped out of the water in the first film, so I'm marking October 13th for this one. There's been plans to bring Stephen King's Geralt's game to the big screen for years now, and it looks like he will finally actually get a movie based on his legendary writer's 1992 novel. Netflix is bringing the project to life and has Mike Flanagan attached to direct it. Flanagan has had a good year, with both Hush and Oculus, Origin of Evil, getting good receptions, and he has described this project as a dream project of his, so Geralt's game will surely be something to look forward to. Get Out is a new Blumhouse production film that they are hoping will hit theaters on February 24th. It looks like an interesting film that blends social commentary and horror. And considering the political climate in the US these days, I'm guessing this is something we're going to see more in horror films in the upcoming years. While the story looks interesting, I have to say that the trailer annoyed me a bit in that it basically told an entire story. Hopefully, comedian turned first time director Jordan Peele still has a few tricks up his sleeve. And how great, another Hellraiser movie. Some franchises just refuse to die, don't they? And since it will probably be your first question, no. Doug Bradley is not back as Pinhead, and they are not leaving the character alone, as Pinhead will take part in this new film. Hellraiser Judgment will be the 10th movie in the Hellraiser saga, and it is written and directed by Gary J. Tunnicliffe, a guy who has done plenty of work in horror movies over the years, and he was actually also involved in the previous Hellraiser movie, Hellraiser Revelation from 2011, as he did both some makeup effects and created the story for the film. Considering how terrible that one was, I don't have high hopes for this one, to be honest. But who knows, you should never dismiss a movie before it's out, I guess. But what is up with the misspelling of Judgment in the title? I Spit on Your Grave, Deja Vu is an interesting one. Apparently, this one is ignoring the new remake trilogy, and instead it is a direct sequel to the original and infamous rape revenge movie, I Spit on Your Grave, from 1978. Not only that, but it also brings back original director Meir Sarchi, who hasn't directed a film since 1985 when he released Don't Mess With My Sister. Sarchi is united once again with the star of the original film, Camille Keaton, who will reprise her role as Jennifer Hills, who has written a best-selling book regarding the torture she went through in the first film. Some relatives from the original trio of demented fuckheads gets mad at her for this and sets out to bring more torture upon her. It sounds like an insane plot for a sequel nearly 40 years later. The film is apparently completed, but little news of it has hit the net this year regarding a release date. But if the footage has been shot, then there should only be time before we get this very unusual sequel. On October the 20th, the fourth Insidious film will hit theaters worldwide. And personally, this is probably my most anticipated movie of 2017. I have a fondness for the Insidious series, especially due to the sequel being one of the best horror movies out there the last 10 years. While the third film wasn't the greatest thing ever, I still believe that the franchise has potential to bring out more great movies. Lynn Shay is returning yet again as Elise, and the story is supposed to follow directly from the third film. Adam Robitel is getting the chance to direct this one, and coming off the well-received The Taking of Deborah Logan from last year, there should be enough potential here to scare audiences worldwide yet again. 2017 looks like it will be a fun year for fans of Stephen King. Well, depending on how we feel about this one. On September 8th, the remake of It will go into cinemas. The 1990 miniseries has some loyal fans that will dislike this new film no matter how good it will end up becoming. That's just the way it is when it comes to remakes. I love the miniseries and aren't all that jazzed about a new version of Pennywise coming out myself, but absolutely understand the idea of bringing the character back to a new audience. I must say that I'm curious about what this film will be, and are looking forward to seeing a trailer for it whenever it drops. Juleblod is a new Norwegian Christmas horror movie that will be released in November, at least in this country. Juleblod can be translated into Christmas Blood, and this is directed by Reinert Kiel, who has become a prominent B-movie filmmaker in this country. I must say I'm not a fan of his stuff at all, but I am happy to see a Norwegian filmmaker being able to create the stuff he wants in this country. Fans of his film should be excited for this, and fans of Christmas horror in general can look forward to a new film that I'm gonna just guess will be filled with rough violence, nudity, and all the other stuff that exploitation fans love. Kodoku Meatball Machine is a sequel to the Japanese splatter movie Meatball Machine from 2005. The director this time around is Yoshihiro Nishimura, who is very familiar with the crazy insane Japanese splatter genre, as he's the director of stuff like Vampire Girl vs Frankenstein Girl, Mutant Girl Squad, and of course, Tokyo Gore Police. The trailer for this film is absolutely bonkers, as expected, so fans of this type of Japanese cinema should have something to look forward to. So, we're getting a new Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie. Leatherface will give the focus on Leatherface when he was a young teenager. He kidnaps a young nurse and then escapes from a mental hospital together with three other inmates and takes her on a road trip. I haven't even seen the last Texas Chainsaw movie, simply titled Texas Chainsaw 3D from 2013, as I haven't been excited for this franchise in quite a long time. The interesting part of this one, however, is that it's being directed by the French duo Alexandre Bustillo and Julien Maury. They broke out big time with the 2007 movie Inside, and they followed that one up with Livid in 2011 and Among the Living in 2013. Both with a lukewarm reception, before now getting the United States debut on this Texas Chainsaw franchise. The film is supposedly completed several months ago, so hopefully that trailer and release date will pop up soon for Leatherface. If you mention the idea of having a cinematic universe, chances are high that people will associate the term with Marvel Cinematic Universe. What many might not realize though is that the good old Universal Monster movies did this over 75 years ago, with the beloved characters of Frankenstein, the Mummy, Dracula, and many more. They are attempting to reboot this universe, with Tom Cruise starring in a new Mummy movie. And before the one guy out there screams, "What about Dracula Untold?", it has been confirmed that they are not considering that to be part of the new universe anymore. The new Mummy movie will hit cinemas on June 9th. Surely with a big marketing campaign behind it. The first trailer for the film is out and it looks a bit more action than horror, but I guess we shouldn't be surprised at that, to be honest. I'm sure it will be a big spectacle though, so look out for it, and if it is successful, we will get more characters back from the past, and in my book, that's a good thing. Back in 2015, Tom Savini and Umberto Lenzi teamed up to make an Indiegogo campaign to secure enough funds to create a remake of Lenzi's 1980 B-movie classic, Nightmare City. They got more than the $100,000 that they asked for, but due to different reasons, the filming hasn't even started yet, but are scheduled to be done during spring of next year. If you are lucky, then a final product might be out before the end of the year, although I wouldn't count on it, to be honest. It should be funny to see how this project will turn out, even if I'm not a huge fan of the original film by Lenzi, so on this one, call me semi-intrigued. Polaroid is a co-production between Norwegian and American production companies, and I see that Dimension Films are involved on this one. It is based on a short film about a Polaroid camera that captures more than just pictures. It is not a unique story, as we've seen plenty of this stuff in J-horror, especially during its golden age in the early 2000s. What sets this film apart, I guess, is the fact that it's directed by a Norwegian. Lars Klevberg did the short film and will be doing the feature film as well. And seeing a movie like this within Norwegian settings should be interesting. I've seen the short and it was enough to make me want to check this one out. It is slated with a release in August, but since it hasn't even started filming yet, who knows for sure when it will actually be released. Puppet Master Axis Termination started as an Indiegogo campaign by Full Moon leader Charles Band. The production has had some delays to it, but are now slated to be finalized and released in April. This one promises to be the final part of the Axis trilogy, which includes the two previous films Puppet Master Axis of Evil from 2010 and Puppet Master Axis Rising from 2012. This is the 11th movie in the Puppet Master series if you ignore the spin-offs, and while I haven't catched up to the last few ones yet, this is another franchise that I'm just happy lives on. Raw is a film that has gained some good buzz during its festival run this year, and will be unleashed upon us regular moviegoers on March 10th. I try to avoid reading much about the plot, so I only know that it's supposed to have cannibalism and a vegetarian character in it. Oh, and that it's supposed to be very disturbing. The few have seen it have said that they would have put it on top of the best of 2016 list if it had gotten released this year, so here's hoping that this will be a new classic from the great people of France. On February 7th, we are finally getting a new Reanimator movie. First off, Reanimator Evolution will not feature Jeffrey Combs as Dr. Herbert West, as the character has been recast with actor Jonathan Schakes, sorry for butchering that name, filling in the role instead. According to director Serge Levine, this will not be a continuation, but rather a modern retelling. I can't say that the idea of a Reanimator movie without Combs being a good one, so I'm wary of how this one will turn out. The release date is set early in February, but considering there aren't even a trailer out, I'm guessing this will be postponed and released later in the year. Late in January, we are getting what is promised to be the final entry to the Resident Evil franchise. The final chapter, and if we all had a dollar for each time a movie called the final chapter would not end up being the final movie in the franchise, we would all at least have 5 bucks. This will be the 6th movie in the franchise, and it is being directed by Paul Anderson, who you can call the father of this franchise, as he has now directed 4 out of the 6 movies. I've still only seen the first one, to be honest, and I didn't care much for that one, so this is not made for me. But fans of the franchise will surely be anticipating Resident Evil The Final Chapter. Finally, it looks like we will be getting the second Return to Nukem High movie, as the now titled Return to Nukem High, aka Volume 2, will have its premiere in New York on January 15. And hopefully it will be made available to the rest of us not too long after that. I enjoyed the 2013 Return to Nukem High, and I will always be curious to see a new Lloyd Kaufman directed movie, so my toxic juices are bubbling full time for Return to Nukem High, aka Volume 2. The Ring franchise is making a surprise return with Rings in cinemas worldwide in the early days of February. This is a big production with a budget over $30 million, and its initial release was supposed to happen during October of this year. It is never a good sign that a horror film is being pushed back and given a February release, but there is always exceptions to the rule, so who knows. Personally, I haven't cared much for any of the American versions of J-horror films anyway, so I'll probably pass up on Rings. Do you miss the era of torture films that the Saw franchise kickstarted? Wait no more, as the 8th Saw movie, Saw Legacy, is hitting theaters worldwide in the upcoming October. Little is known so far regarding the story of this one, but more torture and puzzles is surely to be expected. The director behind this one are the brothers Michael and Peter Spierig. They've done a few movies before this, with the 2009 Daybreakers being the only one I am familiar with. It is rumored but not yet confirmed that Tobin Bell will return as Jigsaw, but I would be surprised if it doesn't at least pop up once or twice during the film. We can't have another new year without a Sharknado movie, of course. Just for the fun of it, I hope they never stop making these films. I haven't seen any of them after the first Sharknado, but the idea of these living on is enough for me to put this in this video. Tara Reid is back as April Wexler, a character that has apparently lived through all 4 previous Sharknados, and I just now realized that all of them have the same director in Anthony C. Ferrante. If there one day is a box set of 10 Sharknado movies, then I will be all over it. While Sharknado 5 Earth Zero doesn't have a release date yet, I'm gonna guess that will be premiering on the Sci-Fi channel sometime during the summer. M. Night Shyamalan is back at the end of January with a new movie called Split. He experienced good reception with last year's The Visit, which I must say I haven't seen yet. The trailer for this new one looks interesting enough, although it is probably not something for me. Fans of the guy though should be happy to see that he's back on his A-game these days, and Split will hopefully not disappoint them. So, the Suspiria remake is currently filming. This is a remake that I have no interest in at all, as I love Dario Argento's Suspiria and can't see a single reason for why this one should be remade. Except that it hopefully gives Argento some well-deserved money for it, I guess. And in a perfect world, this might make someone new check out the original or something like that. The director of the remake is actually also an Italian, as the job has been given to Luca Guadagnino, a guy who has made 20 plus movies that I've never seen or heard much about. None of them being horror films, by the way. Not that that's necessarily a bad thing. So yeah, Suspiria remake, it's coming. XX is a new anthology film that will get a limited theatrical release and a video on demand release on February 17th. XX will feature four tales, all being told by female filmmakers or mostly unknown to me, except Karin Kusama, who has just come off The Invitation and also did Jennifer's Body in 2009 and the box office flop Aeon Flux in 2005. I don't really care about the gender of whoever is creating the films I'm watching, but considering a few female directors that are out there, it is nice to see a project like this come to light. So, there you have it. Hopefully some of these will be new to you and get your interest going for the new year. If you know any other horror movies coming out in 2017 that I haven't covered, then let me know about it in the comment section below. Make sure to subscribe to get updates on my videos in the future, and of course, have a happy new year.